Do you know, this is going to be a really, really interesting book club interview because I didn't know that Cecelia Ahern was wearing black today and I'm wearing black. We are in sync.
Perfect. Apart, we're always in sync.
Well, we're always in sync, apart from the fact that I'm probably about 100 pounds heavier than you, but I mean, because she's like this.
No.
Yes, you are. Cecelia Ahern is our guest at the book club and it's, once again, just good to see you.
Thank you. I love being here.
I'm really glad you do.
This isn't work. This is just a nice chat.
Well, you know, I don't like to call it work. Mm-mm. I like to call it, what is the word? What is it I use? Oh, my goodness. Not, what is it? Not, oh, stuff for which I get paid. There you go.
Yes.
There you go. But not work. Not work. But anyway, I'll find the word soon anyway.
And this is stuff for which I get paid.
And what a beautiful lot of stuff that you do. Actions for which I get paid.
That's the word. I might steal that one.
So we're going to talk today about the year I met you.
Okay.
What I love about a lot of your books is they never quite start, if that makes sense. You've got to weave your way in and there's always something that you've got to get some information about before then you can get to the next stage. And it keeps you very, very engrossed.
Oh, good. That's a good
way. So we have Jasmine now.
Yes.
Now, Jasmine sounds like a lovely girl, homely girl, family girl, but has to stop working, doesn't she?
Yeah.
And I don't want to give too much away, but I mean,
I will.
Well, you go for it then.
I'll give it all away.
You go for it.
She is, yeah, she's in her early 30s and she's a workaholic. She just identifies herself by the job that she has, always had, and always has done that.
And I found that quite dangerous because, oh, sorry, no, you go, and then I'll tell you why I found that dangerous. But anyway, go on.
And she gets fired from her job, and she's placed on gardening leave, which means that she's not allowed to work anywhere for 1 year, which is a prison sentence for her. I mean, a lot of people would love that, getting paid for 1 year of no work. But for her, she just doesn't know what to do with herself. She actually decides to do the gardening. And she doesn't have a garden. She has to dig up the ground and start rooting herself. And a lot of the story is about, I suppose, how she digs into the garden. The more she digs into herself, the more the garden flourishes, the more she does. And the garden ends up being a reflection of her and the journey that she's going on in, throughout the year.
But for somebody, and this is why I found it quite dangerous, that she wasn't necessarily a workaholic, but defined herself by her job.
Mm.
One, you get fired. And then two, because you're in the place of non-identity, because your whole identity has been removed from you, anyone can walk into your life.
Which she does.
And somebody does.
Which she does.
Because she's not, she's lost her identity.
Yeah.
But I think in losing that part of her identity, she finds herself.
Yes. Yeah.
Because Matt's not who Jasmine, workaholic, really would have been attracted to.
Absolutely not. And that's a lot of the theme of the book, I suppose. People that we meet, maybe in our 20s, might not do anything for us in that time of our life. But if we were to meet them again in our 40s, maybe that's the moment that we were meant to come together. And I think that happens. People come in and out of your life at different times and you either have a connection or you don't. And you go on. And what happens here is that Jasmine meets a neighbour who she always despised. He's this shock jock guy who's going through a crisis himself. Not very likeable. Insults everybody. But she realises that's not who he is.
Mm.
And he is the person, surprisingly, who can help her through this journey of, well, she's lost, actually. She doesn't know who she is. So she has to try and figure out who she is and he's there with her.
But doesn't Matt actually accept that the shock jock is a job?
Yes, absolutely. Yeah.
So he is, in fact, the ideal person to teach her that her job is her job and not her.
That's true. Yes.
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 Oh, Cecelia.
She's good.
Don't kiss me, girl. Don't.
But you know what? He's also a wind-up merchant. Yeah. And she's someone who's easily wound up. People annoy her. People's opinions annoy her. She would wish everybody would just be PC and get that injection as soon as they're born and not have to listen to stupid debate about
wake
silly
up
opinions.
Jasmine.
Yeah, I know, but and there's kind of a me part of me in her because it's like, why can't everyone just know the right thing? And I'm not saying that I'm always perfect, but for her she just gets so irritated by people. And he is the most irritating person. He will just throw something in there to have a wild conversation, which just she finds really annoying. So he does that in her life. He's always chucking things in there just to annoy her, to see how she reacts, and they wind each other up. But she just lets go then. She realises, don't take everything so seriously. People have different opinions.
Yep.
I might not agree with his, but that's that's life.
De-stress, girl. De-stress. Okay, now you're in London. Obviously, this new book is out. It's wonderful. But your work just seems to be going from strength to strength, doesn't it?
And it's
brilliant. You know, own it, accept it. It's great.
Yeah.
Love Rosie, which is your last book, which was actually called
Where Rainbows End.
Where Rainbows End. That is now a film.
Yes.
And you're here for the premiere.
Yes.
The last time that we met was because it was 10 years of PS I Love You.
Yeah.
Lots happening for you, Cecelia.
Yeah.
And so, how are you feeling about the end product of Love, Rosie?
Oh, I adore it. I really do. And I wouldn't just say that.
Mm-hmm.
I watched it and I wrote this book straight after PS I Love You. So that was, I was 21 when I wrote that novel as well.
Amazing.
So it's taken over 10 years. It's probably, what is it now? What am I? 12 years.
Right.
To kind of get to this point. The book was optioned over maybe 7 or 8 years ago. And it's such a long journey to get to here. So it's amazing. When I see the story, this beautiful love story, which it stars Sam Claflin and Lily Collins.
Yeah.
And I just think back to this little girl, I was a woman, but who wrote it. And I just, it brings me back to that time in my life where I was like that character, searching and wondering and what life got in store for me, and learning that life has, you've got to grab life and take control of it yourself and make things happen instead of just sitting back. And I suppose that's a huge theme of what the story is. Rosie is, she has all these plans, but they don't quite work out. And so she's waiting, waiting. When will they happen? When will they happen? Then eventually she realises, I've got to make it happen.
Make it happen, yeah.
And so, it's about, I suppose, the friendship between these two people from the age of 5 all the way up to, in the novel, 50, in the movie, 30.
Yeah. I love the fact that love is the centre of a lot of your writing.
Yeah.
And you know, when I say love, you know, real love, not the stars and the daffodils and the rabbits popping around, but love and everything that goes with it, the ups, the downs, the learning, the pain, the overcoming, but the final result being.
And friendship and companionship, I've realised, is something I write kind of more about. People say, are you going to put some steamy sex scenes in? And I kind of concentrate on the friendship journey and the growing and moving together. Well, you know, I think sometimes you're going to go in different directions, but you have to learn how to just stay on the same path while that happens. And that's what they've all been about. And The Year I Met You isn't necessarily a heavy romance, mm-hmm. but it is definitely about love.
Yeah.
And about the friendship between these two people.
Wonderful. Well, read about Jasmine and Matt. I could talk to you for ages, but I think if we don't wind it up here, you and I will never, ever stop talking. Always lovely to see you.
And you, thank you.
We look forward to the next book, and I will be going to see Just Rosie.
Yay!
Just Rosie. What did I say?
Don't just see Rosie. See Rosie and Sam.
And I will be going to see the film. Cecelia Ahern in The Year I Met You. It's this week's Book of the Week. Thank you so much.
Thank you.